From far beyond the galaxies, I've journeyed to this place to study the behavior patterns of the human race. And I find them highly illogical. Girl meets boy. They fall in love. She says he's everything she's dreamed of. But when they get married, before he's aware, she changes his habits, the way he combs his hair, changes him to someone he's never been, and then complains he's not like other men. Now really, I find this most illogical. Take the case of your automobiles. Greatest invention since man discovered wheels. Hydromatic overdrive, four on the floor. Push button windows, push button doors. Double barrel carburetors rush you any place, but you never can find a parking space. Highly illogical. Take the case of modern man. He works all his life. Gives it all he can, saves all his money, works overtime, pinches every penny, banks every dime. All he can think about is money, but you know that he can't take it with him where he's going to go. Now I find that fascinatingly illogical. Now is the time to journey home, to tell of what I've learned. My people, I believe, have every right to be concerned. For in spite of computers and advanced psychology, behavior patterns are still a mystery. I predict the future of this earthly human race is that having made a mess of Earth, they'll move to outer space. Well, there goes the neighborhood. Totally, completely, absolutely, irrevocably, highly illogical.
Stardate 2434.2. First Officer's log. On a routine patrol flight in the Milky Way galaxy, I discovered on our space sensors an unidentified planet careening wildly in an eccentric solar orbit. I ordered an immediate investigation, and with much difficulty, maneuvered our ship for a temporary orbit. Upon beaming down to the planet's surface, all I could see were ruins. Ruins of some type of civilization. Crumbled buildings, deserted streets, charred vegetation, all covered with a thick layer of dust, which our scanners indicated as intensely radioactive. I proceeded to make a thorough survey of the area. According to my calculations, I could tell that some recent phenomenon or holocaust had occurred and destroyed whatever advanced civilization had existed on the planet. I found no sign of life. As I made my way back to the ship, I heard a sound. It came from a cellar in one of the nearby buildings. Carefully and slowly, I found my way to the source and discovered a human being. Or rather, what once was a human being. A scarred, disfigured man lying in the rubble. When I questioned him, he told me that this had once